Hi guys, in this video I'm going to talk about associative memory. This associative memory is similar to the simplified model of human brain, which can associate similar patterns. This associative memory is similar to our human brain. Like, how do we recognize some patterns? Like, if you remember Sachin Tendulkar, then you remember Sachin Tendulkar belongs to cricket, or Sachin Tendulkar for scoring 10,000s of run. So you are considering a pattern, and based on the pattern, different memories recognize, or you recall different other pattern. So this is what associative memory network do. It takes one input pattern and produces similar patterns corresponding to it. It exhibits hebbian learning. This associative memory network exhibits hebbian learning. We have talked about hebbian learning, that when there is a change in the synaptic gap, then our learning rate is improved. And associative memory is a storehouse of associated patterns which are encoded in some form. When a storehouse is triggered with a pattern, the associated pair is recalled. In associative memory, we have a storehouse that have associated patterns which are encoded in some form. Now, when this storehouse is triggered or initiated with a pattern, the associated pair is recalled. For example, this is our storehouse. We have division, 0, 1, minus 1, multiplication, division. Now, if you recall 0, that is binary 0, then what do you recall corresponding to 0? You will not recall plus, divide or multiplication. But if I am talking about binary, then if you recall 0, then definitely you will recall 1. So in associative memory, we have a storehouse of associated patterns, and once an storehouse is initiated or triggered, then corresponding patterns are recalled. Or associative memory can be classified as static and dynamic network. This associative memory can be classified in two parts. First is the static. In static part, recalls output in single feed forward pass. When you are talking about static associative memory, it is similar that you given an input and on one run you get the output. Like, if you recall Sachin Tendulkar, in one feed forward network you will record how many century the Sachin Tendulkar have scored. Now coming to the dynamic associative memory. Dynamic associative memory recalls through recurrent pass. Recurrent pass means you have given an input to the operator and it will generate an output. This output is given again to the operator as input, and again an output is generated, and now again this output is given to the operator as an input, and now it will generate the output. This process goes on until you find the perfect match. Like fingerprint scanner. Like, if you touch the fingerprint scanner, or if you have seen how fingerprint scanner works, it asks you several times to touch on the fingerprint, and first it will take the input based on which it will generate some output, and based on which it will again generate some output, and this process goes on until it finds the complete match. This was the two type of associative memory. Mainly, auto associative memory are of two types. First is the auto associative memory, and second is the hetero associative memory. In auto associative memory, we get the same input and output pair. Suppose you recall a teacher, of your school. Now, if you are recalling your teacher, then you will recall the similar things. What was his dressing sense? Do the teacher wear the specs, or the teacher hair was short or long? So you are recalling an input pattern teacher, and you are recalling the same output patterns related to him. This is auto-associative memory. And what is hetero-associative memory? Associative patterns are different. If you are recalling your teacher, now you will recall in which class this teacher has taught me, or in which school this teacher was present. You are recalling an X, and now corresponding to the value you get the Y. This is hetero-associative memory. If you are recalling X, you will get some associated pattern Y. In auto-associative memory, if you are recalling some X, you will get complete X. So input and output pair are same. In hetero-associative memory, input and output pair are different. So this was associative memory.